We know how to find edges and corners in images. And then we also know how to take these edges and corners and then compute the boundaries of objects in images, which is very useful in computer vision. Now let's talk about the problem of object recognition. In particular, recognizing objects with fairly complex appearances. In this case, you want to be able to detect and match features that are fairly descriptive and unique. And that's what the SIFT feature detector does for us. But let's start with a little quiz. So here is an image shown to you, and the question is, what technique would you use to recognize the objects in this image? But this is a fairly simple one. We know from our lecture on binary image processing that we can probably apply a threshold to this image and get a nice, clean binary image, and then compute the geometric properties of these objects in the binary image to recognize them, to find their orientation and their position as well. So that's an easy one. Now let's take a look at this image right here. So here again, maybe a slightly more complex image, but once again, you can imagine that you can apply some kind of a thresholding scheme to extract the letters and numbers on these license plates, and then use a simple recognition technique to find them, to recognize them, and read out these license plates. Not too hard. Now let's make things a little bit more interesting and consider this case. So here is what we call a 2D object. It's a planar object, but with a fairly complex appearance. And we want to find this object in this image right here. So what technique would you use? Well, your first instinct may be to use something like template matching. We know how to do that using normalized correlation. But the problem is that the object doesn't show up exactly in its original form in the image. It's actually rotated in the image and is also magnified differently. In other words, it has a different scale in the image. And so in order to deal with rotation and scale, you might have to then create lots of templates of this object under different rotations and scales and apply each of one of those to the image, which would be computationally just impractical. But actually the harder problem here is occlusion. You see that this object is actually obstructed by other objects. This is hard. And so dealing with that using template matching might require you to actually create a lot of little templates here from this object and then apply each one of those and make sure that in your final output there are enough templates of this object that appear in a certain geometric configuration, and if they do, then you declare that you have found the object. A very computationally intensive process and doesn't scale very well. But instead, what we would like to do is somehow extract directly from this image that's given to you some very descriptive, unique features. So if you can find these features, and if you can find the same features in this image, then we can match them and we can recognize the object. And that's exactly what the SIFT detector does. So SIFT is short for Scale Invariant Feature Transform. And we'll describe the theory behind the SIFT detector and its implementation, and also show how it's used to solve some interesting vision problems, simple vision problems such as image alignment and stitching, as well as 2D object recognition. So we're going to start with asking the question, what is an interest point? By the way, this is an area of research in computer vision that has a long history. I think the term interest point really came from Hans Moravec back in the late 1970s. He was looking at what are interesting points in the context of robot vision. And since then, there's been a lot of work in this area that goes to say that edges and corners are not really interesting enough points for a lot of applications. We need things that are a little bit more descriptive. And what has been realized over time is that some notion of a blob, which has some local appearance within it, is potentially a very good interest point to try and find and to use for matching as well. So we'll talk about detecting blobs. By the way, I should mention once again that blob, the term blob is being used very loosely here. It's a patch with a local appearance. And we'll use derivatives of images to to actually detect blobs, very much like what we did with edge detection. We'll create a theory for blob detection. And what's nice about this theory is that it can detect blobs over multiple scales. It can handle not only the position of the blob, but also the magnification of the blob, because an object can appear at many different magnifications depending on its depth from the camera. So you have to be able to deal with scale. And so this blob detection theory handles scale in a very elegant manner. And using this theory, we are going to develop the SIFT detector, which was proposed by David Loeb. It's a very clever, very clean implementation of blob detection. And we'll see how it's done. And we'll also show that it is very robust and reliable in terms of extracting interest points from images. Now, that brings us to the point where we can actually detect these points in any image that's given to us. But in order to match a point in one image to a point in another image, in other words, an interest point in one image to an interest point in another image, you really need some kind of a signature that describes the local appearance around the point. So that brings us to the SIFT descriptor. We'll see how we can extract such a description or signature from each one of these blobs, and how to make that signature independent of rotation, scale, and insensitive to things like lighting.